Good morning. Right now it's 8:59. If you're watching on Facebook, go ahead and let me know, what do you have going on today? It is going to be an awesome day. It's Thursday, January 23rd, and I found out that yesterday was the five-year anniversary of KHEA Radio being on the air. So today is a celebration because, honestly, I just forgot. Just forgot that yesterday was the five-year anniversary, but it's a big deal. So I'm excited that you're taking this opportunity to hang out with me on social media. Smash the like button, smash the share button, even more importantly, smash that share button. Let me know what you have going on today. Today I have Jacob in studio. I have Megan in studio. We're going to be talking about manifesting your soulmate. What does that mean? We're going to be finding out. Have you found your soulmate? Yes, no, maybe. Maybe you're looking. Maybe you'll find that person today. You'll be able to manifest them. So we got Jacob, Megan. How are you guys doing today?
We are doing amazing. Gardy, thank you so much for having us on KHEA Radio. This is my beautiful wife, Megan.
Nice to meet everyone.
What's up, Megan? How are you doing today?
This is really incredible. Thank you for having us on. We really appreciate this.
Of course, of course. So manifesting your soulmate. Whenever I hear the word manifest, I think of a cauldron. I think of somebody with like a paddle and like sprinkling packets of what in my head looks like Kool-Aid and just like, okay, we're going to make this happen. I'm finding my soulmate today. What does that mean? You know, manifest.
So there's a scripture that I like to talk about when I think about the word manifestation, and it comes right from David. As a man thinks in his heart, so is he. And we have the creator within us based on what Jesus has done, to where we have the ability to do things as great and greater than Jesus did, as he said.
He said that, yeah.
So if we're made in the image of God, we have creative ability. And you create every single moment from moment to moment by the thoughts and feelings that you're holding within. So as a man or woman thinks as in his heart, so is he.
Wow. I like that. That got deep really quick.
So definitely not a cauldron.
No cauldron.
Not a cauldron.
You use your mind.
Maybe some Kool-Aid
heart.
Or
yeah.
tea and coffee. Right?
That's right.
Okay. I like that. So we're going to go ahead and kick it on to the FM. If you're watching on Facebook, thank you. Good morning. Let me know what you have going on today. Have you found your soulmate? Maybe you're still looking, and we're going to be learning what that looks like. And, you know, things that you can do to maybe speed up the process. But do you want to speed up the process? I don't know. Here we go. This is KHEA Radio, 99.5 FM. Right now it's 9:01 on a Thursday. This is Kickstart. I'm Gardy. I'm hanging out with some friends. They are new friends. I got Jacob and Megan here in studio. What's up, guys? How's it going?
Oh, amazing. We're loving life. It's a beautiful day.
Yeah. So, Jacob, I met you, I'm going to say in December, towards the end, right? Mm-hmm. And I asked you, you know, what do you do? And you're like, well, kind of a lot. And you kind of were listing some of the things that you were doing. And then you had not had your baby. Y'all just had a baby, right?
Yeah.
She's 1 month old today.
1 month old today.
Mm-hmm. Birthday, yep.
So there's a lot going on. One of the things that you have going on is, you know, a podcast, maybe some other outlets as well, but I'm not sure. So manifesting your soulmate.
Mm-hmm.
Where did this idea come from? And what does that mean to you, manifesting your soulmate?
Megan, do you want to go? So, I don't want to talk too much.
Yeah, so where it came from was Jacob and I had an incredible story, basically, of how we met, how we came together, and how we made the decision to commit to each other. And we are currently writing a book on it, and we cover the whole story and exactly what we did to get there. But when we took a step back after the last, it was basically a year that all this craziness unfolded, and we realized that God was speaking to us in so many incredible ways. We realized that when we took a step back, that we had taken certain steps to create this kind of love. So we had to come to a place within ourselves to accept each other and to accept that kind of love, and come to a place in our lives and in our community and in ourselves to do
that. Yeah. So when did y'all meet?
So it's really interesting. So they say when you actually meet your soulmate, before you actually come together, you have met someplace before, whether it's in school, at work, you know, even if it's just in passing, and you only come together with your soulmate when both of you are in a place in yourself where you're ready to manifest that beautiful love in your life. The very first time we met was December 14th, 2017. We were actually at a personal development retreat a weekend, just shut off your mind, get it, you know, get quiet, and just plan for the next year in Toronto, Canada, where Megan is from.
Oh, cool.
Canadian.
Yeah.
Canadian. And while we were there, we made eye contact, but we never spoke. In fact, I was in a relationship at that time, and she was also in a relationship at that time, and neither of us, you know, obviously were in a position to meet each other.
Mm-hmm.
But the first time we officially spoke was November 9th, 2018.
Okay. So y'all saw each other in 2017 at a retreat in Canada. Do you go to a lot of retreats? Had you been to Canada before?
I had been to Canada before. I have a lot of business up there as well. And, you know, doing personal development and just taking long weekends to go within myself and just connect with God and just say, like, where are you taking me? What's this next year going to look like? It's something I do often. It's something I highly recommend.
So y'all spoke. It took a year. Did you see it at another event, or did you make it happen? Were you like, how did it go?
We left that retreat without each other's contact information. So there was no reason for us to ever meet again, because I'm from Canada. I would never, you know, be in a situation to meet somebody from Texas, you know?
Yeah.
So we accidentally just happened to meet again at the same retreat.
The same place.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Was that in your mind, though?
No.
No, it wasn't.
0%, nothing. Like, we were not thinking about that at all. In fact, we both just got out of, I wouldn't say really long relationships, but fairly serious relationships.
Yeah.
And we made that decision within ourselves that I want to focus on me. My love, my health, my career, myself at this moment is my top priority. That's where we both were at when we met each other.
Yeah. You know, sometimes it sounds cliche, but, you know, with it being 2020, like new year, new me, I'm going to work on myself, you know, everything else. I'm going to go work out, get in shape, you know, my mental space and all that. But that is the key to having, you know, being happy with yourself, I guess, before you can learn to be happy with someone else.
Exactly. Exactly, Gardy. In fact, if you don't love yourself, when love shows up in your world, you will reject it.
Yeah.
Because if you don't love you, and somebody else loves you, it's like, what do you want from me? How could you love me? I don't really love me. But right. If I really love me, I emanate. My pure essence is my energy. Everything that I'm showing up as is loving. And the way you manifest love is by being love.
Okay. You know, what if somebody doesn't know, or maybe they think they do, but they don't know what love looks like, what like real genuine love looks like? Maybe they didn't have it, you know, growing up or not, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. What about then?
So do you mean within an external situation, or do you mean with their relationship with themselves?
I think both. Maybe even the relationship with themselves, you know, if they've never seen a healthy relationship with their parents or maybe their siblings got married and they just think that's the way it's supposed to be, you know, and it's not healthy. It's not, maybe not a good example of love.
Yeah. I think it's definitely an overall feeling, but I think what we learned in our journey to love ourselves was the path of forgiveness and true acceptance. And we had to look at things in our lives that we may not be the most happy about, like, you know, certain behaviors or, you know, whatever it was, and come to that realization of complete and total forgiveness and complete love towards that. So that's what we learned on that journey. So I would say love is about forgiveness and about acceptance.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You know, in there's a lot of times people, maybe they didn't have a father figure or a mother figure or just like an example of love. And that's whenever I feel like church and God and, you know, forgiveness can come into play and be an example of, well, this is real love, you know, no matter what, unconditional love.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
exactly.
And another thing I have to say about that is love starts right here, right now with you. And if you're a person who's lived your entire life, you know, talking negatively to yourself, being overly critical, beating yourself up for not being perfect, accept the love that is available for you right now inside your own human heart. That is God's favorite place to live. God is right there right now. And whenever you're not driving and you just find a moment to get quiet, you can just put your hands on your heart and just say, God, you know, I want to hear from you. I want to feel you. What is love? Because love is God. God is love.
Yeah.
And when you surrender to love and trust life, which is God, God is everything, everywhere, all the time. When you surrender to love, and trust life and truly want it, not just say, oh, it would be great to have a soulmate, and then just every other action, every other thought completely conflicts that. But when you really want it, God gives you a 100% guaranteed success rate. You will always get what you want if you really commit to it and absolutely choose, this is what I'm having, this is what I'm having, and choose to focus on love and see love everywhere all around you all the time.
Yeah. So let's talk and go back to y'all's story. So 2017, mm-hmm. y'all see each other for the first time at this event in mm-hmm. Canada, of mm-hmm. all places, mm-hmm. which Megan, you're from Canada.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And then 2018, again, is there contact initiated? Y'all start talking. How does that go?
I could start. Megan, we can fill it in. So this is what people are going to be able to read about in the book. This is such a great story that we looked back on the entire thing after it all happened and we said, this has God written all over it. And when God blessed us with this purpose in our lives to share this message with the world for how we manifested each other and how we can teach people to manifest their soulmate, we see it as our mission to give more people the opportunity to experience love on this planet, because God's freely gifted us this information. It's not ours to keep. It's ours to share everywhere, every time, with every person. So I'm not an early person, but somehow on this day, I was early. I was very early. Megan was also extremely early.
Our GPS literally got us to the place an hour before we were supposed to be there by accident.
Yeah. So God works in very mysterious ways. And I walked in and she was the first person I saw, and we had never spoke before, but we both remembered each other. So I just walked up to her and said, hey, you know, hey, I remember you from last year. How are you? And then she said, oh, you know, I'm so good. Da 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 da. Caught up with me a little bit. And then she said, what are you up to? We got caught up. And then I saw she was actually wearing an engagement ring on her finger. And I said,
never mind.
And I said, what? Oh, you got engaged. Congratulations.
Yeah, yeah,
and
yeah.
And then
yeah.
she said,
I was like, I am engaged to myself.
What does that mean?
Exactly. So that.
So were you wearing that as like a, just in case if somebody asked me, like, you know, as a repellent? Or
no, it wasn't a repellent, but okay. it did work very well for that. But so what happened was that first retreat that we ever laid eyes on each other, God spoke to me and explained to me that the reason why I was having issues in my life is that I didn't love myself and I needed to commit to myself first. So when I got home from that retreat, I broke up with the boyfriend I was seeing.
See ya.
And I really focused on myself. And I wanted a physical reminder of my commitment. So I went out and I did the whole process. I went out to a jewelry store. I went ring shopping and I picked my ring. I had it sized. And it was a whole situation.
You went to like a legit jewelry store?
Yep. And I had
it sized.
Do you
still have the ring?
I do. I actually, yeah, I have it in my jewelry box as a little memento. But
cool.
And I wore it every single day. And when I would put it on in the morning, I would say, you know, this is my commitment to myself. I love myself. And when I would take it off at night, I would say the same thing. And I speak with my hands all the time. So it was a constant daily reminder. People would ask me about it. Oh, you're so young. How come, you know, you're engaged? Like, what's the situation? And I would say, no, this is my commitment to myself. And I was constantly reinforcing that. And literally a couple months later, I had a real engagement ring.
Wow. That's cool. So I like that. So you know, you had that process.
Mm-hmm.
You know, God told you, hey, you need to work on yourself, love yourself. And I mean, where did you even get that idea to go get the ring?
It just
makes sense
to me. It probably was exactly from God. God was like, hey, you need something to really focus, because I'm just a very visual person.
Okay.
So I needed more than just like this idea of, oh, I'm just going to love myself. I'm just going to commit to myself. Like
yeah.
I needed a little bit of a more structured situation.
Yeah. And Jacob, during that same time, were you doing something similar, you know, working on yourself?
I didn't engage myself, but, you know, in an unstructured way, since I was 16 years old, I would just literally start reading the Bible for hours. And it's almost like the words would come off the page and come into me. And it would almost be like a conversation while I was reading. I know some people can relate. When you're reading the Bible, you just really feel God talking to you through certain messages. And I realized I was a very, very sensitive person. And I could, you know, hear God's voice a lot more than I thought other people could. And ever since about age 16, I've at least done my very, very best to spend every single day being sensitive to God's voice, using discernment and just saying, you know, what is God saying to me? And every time I find something that I need to make better or improve, I trust God and I do it.
Wow. That's cool. You know, I've had a friend tell me that, you know, when somebody has a sensitive spirit, that you do allow yourself to be more open to, you know, hearing God's voice. Mm-hmm. And sometimes people are like, well, I don't hear God. Like, I don't hear God, or like, God, speak to me. And the Bible is literally the word of God.
Like, exactly.
It's the word of God. Like, yeah. If you're looking for something, you know, and you can read the Bible and that's him speaking to you.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
And then you can also have other things that he says to you, or like revelations,
ideas,
from the exact
dreams,
same scriptures. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then mm-hmm. things go off of that. So
yeah.
That's really a great way to kind of spark that. Mm-hmm. And sometimes people just don't realize
it. You got to get quiet. You know, we're really busy. There's so much electromagnetic energy with all of these cell phones and computers and TVs, which all of those are very, very major blessings in this day and age we live in. But I get connected with nature at least once per day. I go out in my backyard. I got a lot of plants and stuff like that, growing fruit trees and stuff in the backyard.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I'll just find myself looking into the clouds and looking at birds and looking at animals and looking at nature. And Mother Nature is such a blessing.
Yeah.
God gave us Mother Nature to nurture us. And in those moments when you get quiet, you might get an inspiration from a thought or a feeling or an experience or a direct word. One of those mm-hmm. four. Thought, mm-hmm. word, I'm sorry, thought, feeling, an experience in your life, or a direct word that you can almost even hear inside of you.
Yeah, that's really cool.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. So y'all meet, you know, mm-hmm. you've been working on yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You had the ring, y'all had the conversation. You know, what happens next?
So we were communicating and we're both entrepreneurs. And I just said, oh, congratulations, you're engaged. And she said, no, actually, I'm engaged to myself. And if I would have acted out what I thought, I like would have fallen back completely on my back with like my hands and arms up. Because like what I appreciate most personally is somebody who values and loves themselves, because I value and love myself. And we're all children of God, but not everybody acts like it. Not everybody acts like an heir to the throne that God has given us. We are royalty. You know, we are his children. And the thing that you must understand when manifesting your soulmate is that you've got to love yourself. You've got to know your value. You've got to see your value before anybody else will. So when I see a woman that respects herself in that way, I was very intrigued. I said, wow, this is not something I see at my age usually. You know, I'm 26, Megan's 24. This was a year ago. And I just thought, oh my gosh, that's amazing. So then we get to talking, and then I said, how old are you, by the way? She said, 23. I just had a birthday. I said, oh, when's your birthday? She said, October 24th, 1995. And I said, no way, my birthday's October 19th. But here's where it gets really crazy. This is crazy. But I had actually just gotten out of a relationship with a woman who was born on October 24th, 1995, between the hours of 2 and 3 p.m.
So it was the same birthday?
Megan was born October 24th, 1995, between the hours of 2 and 3 p.m.
Wow.
Literally the same hour.
I have a type.
I have a type.
He's a very specific type.
Yep. Yep.
Yeah.
So what that meant to me was, okay, if you guys could see my face, it's kind of like the cross-eyed, like, what?
Yeah.
And I didn't
like,
know
what are the chances.
I didn't know what to think of that,
right?
But I just thought, okay, God must be using this experience and that experience to speak to me in this scenario in some way. But the even crazier thing is, on October 24th, 2018, which was just 2 weeks before November 9th, I was in Milwaukee, Wisconsin. My cousin and I were going to a basketball game, and there was a homeless person on the side of the street that I decided to help out and give some money. Well, God works in very mysterious ways. I came back to the car after the game, and my entire bag was stolen, with my wallet, with my passport, with all my cards.
They broke into the car.
From your car.
From the car, and a lot of personal belongings. And that's what I thought at first. I said, I was almost like Jesus on the cross, like, my God, why have you forsaken me?
Yeah.
But I just said, you know what? God loves me, and God, my ways are not God's ways. I don't know what this means. Let me just go ahead and trust life. And I actually had to go to Houston on Friday, like the very last day possible, to get my emergency one-day passport from the downtown Houston passport office before my flight was leaving to Canada the next day, because my passport was stolen. And it was such a crazy story that I literally had to keep pushing through in order to get to this person that was waiting for me in Canada, but I didn't know. And the thing that I kind of liken that to is, when life gets tough, are you going to trust God? Are you going to push forward in faith? Are you going to believe the promises that have been given to you? Are you going to just
give up?
Yeah, you could have easily given up. You could have easily said, hey, you know, it's not meant to be. It got stolen. I'm going to have to go get this emergency, you know, passport.
Or just not get it, and I wouldn't be able to go to Canada, and we wouldn't be sitting here right now.
Wow.
Or maybe we would be some other magical way. I don't know. God works in mysterious ways, but
yeah.
But the thing was, it was stolen on her birthday. So one thing you also must understand is that when you're going to go into another level of your life, when you're going to go into an upgraded experience that you're currently having, you're going to have to get rid of some things. And the things that were in that bag, even though they were sentimental and they were valuable, it was almost like symbolism for just like out with the old, in with the new. And I didn't know what that new was until I got married only 3-4 months later.
Mm-hmm. So after that experience and that encounter, 3-4 months later, y'all knew it's time. Let's get married.
There's a lot more to the story, Megan. Do you want to?
Well, basically, we finally exchanged contact information, but still, there was no vibes. Like, there wasn't a direct, like, okay, this person is going to be my person.
Yeah.
And
we were just friends.
I went home from that retreat, and the first thing I opened Facebook, the first thing I saw was a Facebook Live that Jacob did, and he was explaining, you know, his entrepreneurial, like, experiences and all that kind of stuff. So I commented, and I said, next time you're in Toronto, please invite me to one of your talks.
Cool.
And he had reached out to me and said, you know, just started a conversation with me. That night I ended up having a dream about him teaching me how to speak to people. And he was like, you know, that's something I can do for you. And we ended up speaking over the phone a couple times. And he had just casually invited me, hey, if you're ever in Houston and you want to check out the real estate market, because I was in real estate at the time, you can totally come down. I'll show you a couple things. And I was like, yeah, okay. I mean, I barely know you, but, you know, for some reason, that invitation kept replaying in my head. And I, for some reason, just opened my laptop up and started looking at flights. And that's so out of character for me, but there was a calling. And And what we talk about in the book is you have to just surrender to these callings and really trust that your intuition is right. Your intuition is God speaking to you. And you need to follow that if you want to see the results in your life of pure love and, you know, magicness, you know? So, we couldn't figure out dates, and we just finally picked a date, and I landed in Houston December 14th, 2018, and I've never left.
And you didn't go back?
No.
You didn't? You haven't been back to Toronto?
No. Nope.
Had you been to Texas before?
No, I couldn't go back because of immigration, because we decided to get married.
Yes.
Right? But I ended up going back because my grandfather had passed away. But that was a really beautiful experience because, you know, I got to say hello to the family, and I was pregnant at the time. They got to see our baby.
Wow. And the day of his funeral.
Yeah. It was exactly 1 year to the
was
time.
November 9th, yeah. 2019. 1 year to the day of when we officially met. Now get this. The day Megan landed in Houston was December 14th, 2018. The day we first officially met was December 14th, 2017.
So 1 year to the day that we ever laid eyes on
and
each other.
After she landed, about, I don't know, first day we're getting along great. Second day we actually got in a huge fight. It was just a misunderstanding because when you meet your soulmate, we'll tell you this, there's a lot of energy, passion, drive, all that there.
Two worlds collide.
And it's almost like your entire life has led you to this moment. And sometimes you can have major disagreements because you are almost like two, like it's almost like you're the same person in some ways because two hearts make one. And if you really do believe that there was a person that was made perfectly for you, which some people do, some people don't, I totally do.
You do believe that?
100,000%.
Yeah.
Okay.
Absolutely. You know, God made all of us with every perfect thing in mind. And that includes our perfect divine complement, that beautiful person.
Yeah, I was wondering, I remember being a kid growing up. I grew up in the church, and actually this church. I came to this church when I was about 10 years old. Oh, wow. Is my first time that I came here. Mm-hmm. But my parents, even before that, were, you know, God has somebody for you. Mm-hmm. You know, God has someone for you. God has someone for you. And you just hear that. And, I, you know, I believed it. And then after, there was a time in my life where I was like, I don't know if I believe that anymore. Is there somebody out there that's perfect for me? I don't know. And what do you do if, like, you mess up that situation, or you see that, you know, there was a mistake, or hey, this isn't a good relationship? Like, what happens then? You know?
Are you speaking of a person who might be in a relationship that they're?
It's probably not their soulmate. Let's say God has someone for them, but then, like, you're thinking and listening to this conversation and be like, yeah, maybe I'm married to this person and they are not my soulmate.
So
they need to work on themselves, and so do I.
So you can be happy in any relationship. It completely depends on. I'm not going to give anybody any marital advice here, but
yeah.
what one thing that we're also going to come out with as a following book from Manifesting Your Soulmate is creating love in every moment, or at least as every moment as often as possible once you have found that special person. And if you feel, I can't really go, like, do you really want me to go there? Like, if you feel like you're with somebody that's not your soulmate, it's completely depends on what you want.
Because you can be, I believe you can be in a happy relationship. You can make it, you can make it work.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but.
But you don't want to just make it work. You want magic.
You want magic. But the thing is, you will not meet your soulmate till you're ready. It's unmess upable. It's unavoidable to meet your soulmate. We didn't meet until we were absolutely ready. Until we were at a place in ourselves where we were absolutely ready. You won't meet them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool. Y'all were ready because you had the opportunity to make it happen the year before.
Mm-hmm.
But y'all weren't ready. We were both in relationships.
We both had
a lot that we still needed to resolve within ourselves, because we had negative self-images, mm-hmm. programs, baggage from previous relationships, stuff we saw growing up. We weren't at peace with ourselves quite at that point. If we were, we would have come together, but we didn't. We had a lot still to do to manifest this love that we currently have, and we still work on it every single day. One thing I want to say is that once you find your soulmate, life doesn't get perfect. You know, we have disagreements. Mm-hmm. We have things that we don't agree on still. We have miscommunications, but we love each other more than anything, and we trust each other more than anything, and we have a solid foundation of trust and love and respect where we can communicate with each other honestly and openly, non-violently, not by violently, I don't take that the wrong way, non-threateningly, non-aggressively communicate with each other and say, hey, baby, you know, when you did that, this is how that made me feel. Oh, wow, I had no idea. You know, I wouldn't mean to hurt you. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Adjust the behavior. And then, you know, after a time or two of doing that with each little thing and area in the relationship, eventually you reach an area of overlying peace.
Mm-hmm.
And we still have little disagreements, but they're so much more far and few in between than they were before. And it's just a constant thing of, like, I love me, I love you, I love God. Let's take care of ourselves and each other. Let's communicate. Let's respect each other. Let's have respectful boundaries in our relationship. What are boundaries? Boundaries are the sacred container of your relationship. So for us, like, I don't know what everyone else does with their relationship, but for us, like, we have a very special sacred container that we are in, which means, like, sometimes, like, I see people that are in relationships and they're, you know, out and about, and while their partner's not around, it's innocent, but they're flirty, or they're a little bit extra. And that's whatever, everyone has their own preference. But for me, like, you're taking away from your beautiful, sacred relationship every time that you do that for something that is not even close to that, just for a second of, you know, excitement or just a little zing of energy or whatever by just being a little bit flirty. And it's not something that everybody talks about, but, like, we don't have any of that because it's just not tolerable. Like, there's no point in it. We have very solid boundaries. We're very clear on our communication with each other. And we just say, hey, like, certain communications, certain sentences, certain words, or certain whatever, that stays between us. That's it. There's none of that. Anybody outside of me, any other person outside of me, they're not going to get a vibe from me. Like, period. There's no confusing it. And same thing with Megan. We keep it, you know, when we're dealing with people out and about in our daily life, like, they know where we stand. And we, like, if we're dealing with people in business, we keep it business. You know, and in life, you don't need to be so free or open or flirty with every person to get them to like you or want to be a part of your life, just be respectful, be authentic, respect them. And when you pour all of that energy into your relationship, into your marriage, or into whatever you have going on, that's going to come back to you because you have a safe space of intimacy mm-hmm. between you and your partner. And love can flourish and flourish and flourish like a bamboo garden. It just keeps growing. There's
awesome.
No limit.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
Right now it's 9:29. This is KHEARadio.com, 99.5 FM. This is Kickstart. I'm Gardy, hanging out with Jacob and Megan, talking about manifesting your soulmate. If you're watching on Facebook and you have any questions, feel free to ask. Also, hit the share button. That is very important. Smash the share button. Start a watch party. Share it in a group. Let me know what you got going on today. Maybe you are already with your soulmate, but if you're not, this is some really good advice. You should probably be writing all of this stuff down. Or you can go back and check it out later, or tag a friend. I'm not sure. Whatever you would like to do. Megan, you know, you came from Toronto, mm-hmm. flew down here to Houston,
yep.
and on the second day, energy started colliding.
Mm-hmm.
At that point, did you think, I made a mistake
I'm
coming
here?
I'm
going home. I was like, listen, I'm going to call Air Canada and get my money back. I'm going home right now. I do not want to be here. And it was really interesting because the next day we woke up, and guess where we went?
To the airport?
No, to church. We went to church because it was Sunday.
Okay.
Lakewood?
We went to Lakewood Church.
Yeah, we went to Lakewood, which I didn't know like what the situation was. And then I got there and I was like, oh, that's like the guy. That's Joel.
That's the man, yeah.
I was like, you didn't tell me like that we're going to go to a famous like church, you know? So, we went to church and we were, I don't even know what at what point during that sermon, but I remember we were, there was, they were singing. I don't even remember what hymn it was.
We were
worshiping, and Jacob just had this beautiful moment where he just, like, I just watched him, and mm-hmm. he had a tear roll down his eyes, and that's just when I fell in love.
Yeah.
It was watching him just be so open and so loving and so okay with his emotions and so, you know, just watching this beautiful experience, like, unfold in front of me that whatever I was upset at just rolled away. Mm-hmm. And we had amazing communication when we came back and we realized how silly the disagreement was. It was mm-hmm. it was so silly. It was literally like we were just on the wrong page. We didn't understand each other, which makes sense. We've only really known each other for 2 days at that point.
Yeah. Well, and you know, that's interesting how I'll describe it as, you know, energies colliding. There's a mm-hmm. lot going on, you know, because it was right.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
I mm-hmm. guess. But then mm-hmm. again, it was just a little like you losing your passport, getting your stuff stolen,
mm-hmm.
just a little distraction.
Everything is perfect. You got to trust life and not overreact.
Yeah.
Everything is perfect.
So what do you think? What do you make of all those dates, like the birthdays and all that mm-hmm. stuff? What does that mean? What do you
God
think?
God communicates through experiences, and there are little signposts or little breadcrumbs or little taps on your window, like ding, ding, ding. Hey, I'm just letting you know I'm God
here. Did you notice that? Yeah.
I'm letting you know. And when we look back on it, I mean, that's just scratching the surface. Like, for example, the weekend in Toronto that I met Megan the second time, I actually, while I was, you know, spending time just being with myself and being with my own thoughts, it's almost like a movie screen came up, and in my imagination, I actually saw Megan flying down to Houston. I felt a ton of love, and I saw like this future together, and it all happened, boom, just within an instant. And it was almost like I saw our next 5 years in 5 seconds. And I didn't know what to make of that. I didn't just walk up to her and tell her that because we just met. But when you pay attention to life as it's communicating with you, you can take every bit of information as valuable. So if we weren't supposed to be together, we wouldn't have had mm-hmm. all of those communications from life telling us, hey, you are landing in Houston on 1 year to the day from a year ago that you originally met. Hey, we started our relationship on 12/22. We got married on our 2 month anniversary on 2/22. We actually had a conference in Vegas, a work conference that all of our closest friends and family were going to be at anyways. So we just said, okay, let's go ahead and get married. It just happened to be on our 2 month anniversary, 2/22. Not only that, do you want to talk about the bump that you got?
Yeah, I had a bruise on my arm, and the day of our wedding, it turned into a 2. And I'm not joking. Like
you
an
could
actual
literally, it's like a Harry Potter 2.
Yeah. Wow.
And then it snowed twice.
and it snowed twice in Vegas, and it doesn't snow.
Yeah.
In Vegas.
And I said that was like the first time in so many years.
It was the first time since 1979 that it had snowed twice in a row in Vegas, which was, I think, like 30 or 40 years later in 2019 that happened.
Yeah. So do you think it's important to look for those little signs? I mean, is it possible to look for them too much? I mean, but if it pops and it's undeniable, be like, that's interesting. You know, just kind of roll with it.
You can definitely get a little bit crazy and
like
start
a detective
doing, like,
and be like, so when's your grandma's
birthday? Yeah, and then two plus two is what is four. And then, that's our new. We didn't, like, none of that was planned. And when we looked back, those were the reoccurring things that were happening and the reoccurring numbers, the reoccurring signs that we were seeing. But we never, like, we followed them going forward once we realized what was happening.
Cool.
But we never, like, actively dug. We never, like, you know, okay, we need to get married on this day because, you know, that was literally the only day we could have gotten married for everyone to be there.
Yeah.
You know?
You know, when you talk about dates, I saw my wife just got on the stream. So good morning, Jennifer, to you. But I found this out later after we were married. But, like, my grandma's birthday is on July 3rd. Her grandma's birthday is on July 4th. And I was like, oh, that's interesting. And then, so my wife has a sister, and her mother, so my brother-in-law's mother was born on, like, February 2nd, and, like, my mom was born on February 1st. It was, there's, like, some interesting things like that.
Wow.
I was just, like, one, two, one, two. And there's, like, two more little things like that, just, like, with birthdays.
Interesting, yeah.
Yeah, I just thought it was interesting, but I didn't learn that till later. And it's, like, oh, it's easy to remember, you know, but I always thought, it's a little weird, you know?
If you find something and you're like, what are the chances that would be that? That's probably a sign.
I couldn't make that up. I couldn't just make that up. That is probably God kind of talking to you.
Yeah. So Megan, you get to Houston, second day. There's some things going on. The energies are colliding. Mm-hmm. And then, you know.
Third day, we're in love.
Third day, it works out. You go to Lakewood, had a great experience, right? Mm-hmm. Was there other things prior to Lakewood that you enjoyed about Houston? Did you at least like it here? Is it better than Canada?
I didn't see much, but at that point, I hadn't seen much. But do I like it better than Canada? Absolutely, in terms of weather.
Yeah. Did you have to fall in love with the area, too? I mean, whenever you fall in love with someone or you find your soulmate, I mean, how much of that has to do, obviously it's the person, and maybe you could work anywhere, but is it part of the experience? Like, hey, Houston feels right, the weather feels good, I'm enjoying, you know, the coffee, and just like other things like that.
Well, what's interesting is when I had the opportunity to go back home to Toronto for my grandpa's funeral, I thought, you know, when I got off the plane, I would have this feeling of, wow, I'm home, like this is where I grew up. And when I got off the plane, I was like, I couldn't care less where I am. And I was in the car with Jacob, and we were talking to some people who had picked us up, and I explained, you know, honestly, where my home is with Jacob, and that's where I feel the most comfortable. So it didn't matter to me if I was in Houston, if I was in Toronto, and it was such a shift because I would think, like, I haven't been home in so long. I haven't seen my family. I haven't seen my little obese cat that I miss, you know, and I thought I was going to have this tie to this place, and I didn't, and it was such a shock for me to realize, like, how much I have changed and how much, like, what home and what family means to me is literally here in this room and, you know, with our daughter.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So when is the book coming out? Is it going to be called Manifesting Your Soulmate? Uh-huh.
Manifesting Your Soulmate. So it's written, so we're writing it in two forms. We're writing it from the man's perspective on his story, my story, and then we're writing it in Megan's perspective, her story of us coming together. And then the second part of the book is a personalized guide to help you or anybody create the love of their life. And there's seven things, practices or strategies or different steps that you can take to start to put that into motion. So we just had a baby a month ago. We've been very, very busy with that. Megan is completing her portion of the book. We're going to get it sent off to an editor. The goal was to have it out by Valentine's Day. That might or might not happen, but you can expect it very, very soon.
Okay.
Yeah.
So me as a guy, let's say I was single or I didn't have, you know, my soulmate yet. Would I read from your perspective or from her perspective, or am I reading both?
You'd want to read. Well, do you want to share?
In my opinion, I think reading both, because you want to also understand what your soulmate or what your, like, what your complement is going to go through, the process that they're going to go through.
Yes.
So you can look for the signs, because I had a very, very different process as a woman than what Jacob had as a man.
Okay. And so I am married, and I do believe that, you know, we are soulmates, and I love my wife, and we're expecting our third child, and we're excited.
Congratulations.
As well.
Is there value for me to read this book as well, being married?
Absolutely, because, you know, when you talk about your soulmate on a certain level, like, you are your soulmate. You are the one that you've been waiting for this whole time. You are the one that you've been looking for. We just never know it. So when we talk about manifesting your soulmate, the very first soulmate you're ever going to have is yourself. So we're going to come out with a series of 5 books. We're going to come out with a book on personally the relationship that you have with yourself, and potentially even the relationship that you have with your life. The second one is going to be about dating in a respectful, authentic, you know, way, so on and so forth. Third book is Manifesting Your Soulmate, which that's the book that's coming out first, but it's in the middle of this of the series. The fourth book is on actually manifesting love in your relationship every moment as possible once you're together. And the fifth book is going to be on creating genius children, which there's a formula to that as well.
Awesome. You know, so I was going to ask that, you know, with soulmates and then you have a wild card thrown in and you'll have a 1-month-old baby, mm-hmm. that can change the dynamics. Well, I'll tell you this. It does change the dynamics mm-hmm. of everything. Everything changes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And so I think, you know, that affects your relationship and, mm-hmm. you know.
Yeah, it was very interesting. I did not think it was going to be as hard as it actually is. I was like, oh, yeah, we're just going to have a baby and the baby, you know.
I'd be calling my mom from Toronto. Like, you got to come help me out.
She's
come
coming
on.
Next month. No, Jacob's mom was like a blessing and she was there for us so many times. But we had to change our communication with each other. We had to really help each other because, you know, after giving birth, there's certain things that I couldn't do until my body was repaired. So Jacob had to literally take care of me completely and our daughter, and it was a lot for him. So there had to be a lot of understanding, a lot of grace, a lot of respect, and a lot of communication.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Patience, yeah.
Yeah, a lot of patience. So let's see, right now it's 9:41. This is KHEARadio.com, 99.5 FM. So, you know, there's people that are listening and people watching on social media, and I know some of them are married and I know some of them are single. Let's say somebody is single.
Mm-hmm.
Is there like even like a 3-step process? Like, what's the first thing that you do? You know, if you're looking to find your soulmate and mm-hmm. manifest your soulmate, be in a successful relationship and just do mm-hmm. life together well. Is there, I mean, maybe you have this, but like a 3 or 5-step process, or like what's step 1, 2, 3? God is good.
Just,
you know?
Just to make it simple in the 1, 2, 3, the very first thing you must do is love yourself. And you must even love the things about yourself that you don't like. The things, you must make peace with the situations or the circumstances or the experiences that you've had that are less than favorable, and forgive yourself for letting you have that experience, and forgive another who might have hurt you. Because on a very deep level, they can't hurt who you are. They can't hurt God's picture of you, which is who you are. The mistake that a lot of people make is that when they have an experience that's unfavorable, they let that experience define them, and they hold that on, and they carry it around with them for the rest of their life. And that situation or that circumstance did not happen to scar you or destroy you. It happened to give you contrast and to give you the other end of the spectrum, because you can't have beautiful without somewhat knowing what the other end of the spectrum is. If everybody was just and everything was just beautiful, there would be nothing to compare that to, and it wouldn't even be beautiful.
Yeah.
It
mm-hmm.
wouldn't be beautiful because everything would be beautiful. Therefore, it wouldn't be beautiful because
just average, normal.
Yeah.
It would just be average. So the very first step is self-love, forgiveness, and just trusting life that there's a plan for you. That's the very first step. You got to love yourself. The second step is you can literally create this person. And I mean that wholeheartedly, because
you got to know what you want.
We have creative power within us. And if you sit down with a pen and paper or, you know, your iPad or whatever, you can literally design this person. You can write out exactly what you want. I wrote down a list of 51 things that I wanted to manifest in my dream woman.
That's a lot.
And I met Megan 2 days later.
51 things?
She checked 48 out of 51 boxes.
So there's 3? What were the 3 things that weren't checked?
I think it was something like...
I didn't live in Houston.
She didn't live in Houston. Yeah. She wasn't in my current business. She was in another business. And I think I wanted somebody a tiny bit shorter than me, which Megan is, depending on who you ask, either my height or like a quarter inch taller. But those were the three things. A little bit shorter than me in my current business and lived in Houston. And I got something way better than that.
Wow.
And sorry.
Yeah. No. So what are some of the things that she did check off? And when did you realize? Is that something you're like, oh, that's interesting. You know, she automatically looking at her checks off three. And then as you talk and have a conversation, is that something you just realize as you get to know the person, they check off all these things?
So the very first thing that I wanted more than anything was somebody who valued and loved themselves and put themselves first. Because if you're not putting yourself first and valuing and loving and respecting yourself first, you're not going to, and take this word the right way, but you're not going to command the respect of anybody else. People love people who love themselves. How you see yourself, the world sees you. Mm-hmm. So that was the very first thing that I wanted. Another thing I wanted was somebody that I could see being a very good mother. Because I didn't know, but on a deep level I knew that this person that I was going to be with in this relationship was going to be like my wife, and we were going to have a family, and that's what it was going to be. And I wanted somebody who would be a very good, caring mother. I wanted somebody who was funny, somebody who was beautiful, somebody who was smart, somebody who I could build my dreams with, and we're doing that right now. I wanted somebody who is just my best friend, and it wouldn't matter if the entire rest of the world just went somewhere else. If we were together on an island, we would be fine. We wouldn't need anything else.
Yeah. Wow, that's awesome. So you got the first one, you have to love yourself.
You
got to
love yourself.
Love yourself is step one. Step two, you can pretty much build the person. Get out a pen and get out a little pad and start writing down. Mm-hmm. You know, if you can only come up with five, I guess write down 5, 10, 51,
anything.
52.
You just gotta need a direction so that you can, like, you know, God can provide for you. You need to explain what you want. You can't just, you know, just I'll have whatever, because then you'll have whatever.
Then you'll have whatever.
Know?
Yeah. So what would step three be? Just like wait?
Step three, it's not wait. Because when you wait or want, you're in a place of not having. And what God says is, when you ask for something, believe that you have received it. Not believe that you will receive it. Not believe that one day it's coming, because you always get what you ask for. So if you ask life for, I will have my soulmate one day, you will get that. A state of wanting, which is in its being, not having. In its true actuality, it's not having. Live as if you have received it. When you ask for something, believe as if you have received it. So what does that mean in real life? The internal feeling that you have isn't a one of, oh my gosh, why aren't they there? I need to have this. If you already have it, you don't have to go 7 days a week out looking for them, because you already have them. You don't have to keep wondering and putting all the pieces together in your mind, because you already have them. And the thing is, God responds to your picture of life. So when you already have them and you're living in love with God and yourself all day long, that person's going to enter in your life naturally, versus if you're sitting around saying, I don't have them. Why aren't they here? When is this going to get better? That's all that's going to show up in your life. But
and people pick up on that too. It's very easily, and that's sometimes not the most attractive feature or quality.
Yeah. So you got to live as if you have already received it. There's a quote that says, when you look for love and you look for love, you only manifest your own lovelessness. The only way to manifest love is to those that are loving.
Here's a question that just came in, and I'm going to let you answer, and I think I have a crack at it as well. Mm-hmm. So good morning. Thank you for asking this. She said, hi, how do you explain Eve being created for Adam without any input from him?
That's a really great question. And I believe that God created the two of them together as perfect.
From Adam as well.
So they were divine complements.
Yeah, I'll tell you, they were definitely soulmates. Yeah, he literally took that rib and made it, and you had mentioned yourself, you have to love yourself because that soulmate is a part of you, you know, as Eve was a part of Adam.
Mm-hmm.
And God, you know, he's a very, you know, it's all design, and it's just crazy.
Yeah.
Sometimes I don't try to figure out too much stuff about God, because I realize I'm not that smart.
God's ways are not our ways.
He has a plan. Exactly.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So I don't have a perfect answer for you, and there's no perfect answer for any question, because remember, where I am and where you are and where somebody else is, something might sound different but might mean the same thing to somebody else, and it really just depends on your relationship with God and what it's there for you at this moment. How does this answer this question? Because they were made for each other. They were soulmates. It's just that Adam didn't have a pen and paper at that time to sit down and write down. This was just Eve. This was his soulmate, and they came together because God created them for each other. And I believe Eve was the perfect woman that Adam would have perfectly wanted for himself. And who knows, maybe when God took Adam's rib, he said, what does your dream woman look like? You know, what does this perfect person look like? That's not written anywhere, but there's a lot that might have happened that might not have been just put down. We don't know.
Yeah, and you know what else is interesting? Because you talk about whenever y'all met and the energy colliding. I assume, and this again, this is me assuming, but I can imagine, you know, God says, hey, you can eat from everywhere, you know, except for that one, you know, and I assume there was probably some of energy colliding in that decision for them both to take, you know, the fruit from the tree that they weren't supposed to. Mm-hmm. And that, in my head, it's like, hey, that was day two.
Yeah.
But again, I don't know. They could have lived, I don't know, they for like a month, a year, 10 years, and then, you know, the tree and whatever happened, happened. Mm-hmm. You know, that's what's, it's cool. You know, it's cool to talk about these things and try and figure it out. And there's so many ways that I can do something, and I'm just thinking about all the more ways God can do the same task or any task just by speaking it.
Yeah.
So right now it is 9:50. We have a couple minutes left. We're talking to Jacob and Megan about manifesting your soulmate. Let's talk about, I guess, the podcast. Where can you get it? How often are you going to be releasing them as well?
Mm-hmm. So the podcast right now, it's brand new. It started. You can actually, the way you can find it is go to the Facebook page, The Soulmate Community, and the podcast is posted there, or you can text 85100. You can text the word soulmate, S-O-U-L-M-A-T-E, to 85100. And we're actually going to be sending out text updates when we release our book, when we release new podcasts, so on. And we're going to be recording the podcast 3 times a week. You'll be able to access a new episode every Monday morning, every Wednesday morning, and every Friday morning.
That's a lot. That's a lot.
Yeah.
You know, three times a week.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, most podcasts, like I have some that I listen to and I'm subscribed to, and I'm like, please drop another podcast like once a month. You know, if you're lucky, once a week. But 3 times a week, that's a lot of content.
Yeah.
Yeah. How long are they going to be, you think?
15 minutes. They're short segments, and they're focused on specific things. They're applicable, and you can just take it and chew on it for 2-3 days and make it as much a part of your thoughts as possible, and then the next one comes out. It's just a little bite size.
So if somebody wants to keep up with the release of the book, probably joining the soul manifesting your soulmate community. Yeah. Is that
soulmate,
what it's called?
It's called on Facebook, The Soulmate Community.
The Soulmate Community, or text get the text updates as well.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. Is there anything else y'all would like to share? Even something else not about manifesting your soulmate? Maybe some other business that you have going on, or how somebody can follow you on anything.
Yeah, you know, our goal with this, we never planned to do this. We never made a business plan to do this. This is strictly coming from our heart because, you know, when God blessed us with this information, we figured it would almost be selfish not to share. I mean, there's so many people on this earth who they're good people, they're happy people, but they just don't know that there's actually a process that you can go through to manifest your soulmate. And I tell Megan all the time, you know, we're very blessed. We live in America. We have, you know, great careers. We're great with our finances. We have great family, and I'm sure everybody listening has a lot to be grateful for. But if somehow tomorrow, you know, a tornado hit or whatever, and I lost everything, I would still be one of the richest men in the world. I would be the richest man in the world, in my opinion, because I have my soulmate. I have this beautiful, beautiful woman right here with me. And, you know, we just want to say that it's possible for every single person listening. It's absolutely possible. God made the absolute perfect person of your dreams, because God loves you, and he would only have it that way. God loves love. He wants you to be love. He wants you to be in love, and it can happen for you. And, you know, in order to make this happen in your life, apply what you've heard here. You know, if you really want to take a crack at this, make this happen in your life, follow our podcast, follow our Facebook pages on Instagram. We have a page called Manifesting Your Soulmate, but it's not that active at this point. You could just follow me on Instagram, Jacob Rakowski, JACOBRAKOWSKI.
What's the text number? Somebody asked. What is that again?
It's you text the word soulmate, SOULMATE, to 85100.
85100.
Mm-hmm.
Soulmate, one word?
Soulmate, mm-hmm. one word.
85100. So if you text soulmate to 85100, you will be signed up for some updates on the release of the mm-hmm. book, maybe new podcasts and mm-hmm. little nuggets of wisdom and mm-hmm. love, I assume. Yeah,
yeah, mm-hmm. absolutely.
All right. So spell your last name one more time.
Rakowski.
What kind of name? Like, where's that from? It's, come from, originate?
It's Polish.
Do you eat pierogies?
I love pierogies.
Have you been to Pierogi Queen?
I've been to Pierogi Queen. Megan, go ahead. Go ahead.
I actually grew up, the neighbor beside me was Polish, and I grew up with all the Polish food I could ever want.
Oh, yeah.
And when I came to Houston, I was like, what's your background? And he was like, well, I'm majority Polish. And I was like, okay, well, let's go get pierogies. He's like, what? I was like, you don't know about pierogies? So I took him and we got it, and he just fell in love.
Dude. Talk about your neighbor Jacob, though.
Oh, it's my neighbor. She was Polish, and her son was named Jacob. And
oh, wow.
She grew up next to a little Polish boy named Jacob.
Yeah.
And then now I have a... A real Polish boy that I've
got. A real Polish boy.
Yeah.
Eating some kielbasa,
uh-huh, uh-huh.
pickle soup, and some
and
pierogies.
Some borscht.
Oh, yeah.
Potato and farmer's cheese is my favorite. Mm. Pan fried. I'm a big fan of Pierogi
yeah.
Queen. My friend Josh Varner, he works in the kitchen there in Ava.
Oh, we probably met him then.
Oh, yeah. Next time you go in there, just tell him Gardy says hello. He sends his regards. He's on a detox right now, but he will be back.
He'll be back.
Yeah, those are good people at Pierogi Queen. But Polish food is legit. I didn't realize that. Even if I go to HEB, I always look for something that says kielbasa. If it's like beef, any kind of anything that says kielbasa, it's just better. It's just better.
It is.
Yeah.
It is better.
That's like their thing. Polish sausage.
Yeah.
So Rakowski, it's Polish.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
That's cool. What was your maiden name?
Cooper, but my dad was from all over, just a mix of European, and my mom's actually fully Indian.
Okay.
I'm half Indian.
Had you been to the United States prior?
Yeah, I actually had two properties I was working on, so which is why I was like, oh, okay, well, I'm already traveling in the States. So I was like, okay, let me just come down and let me see, because Jacob's family is in real estate on the side. So they were like, okay, well, we'll just show you some stuff. And I was like, okay.
That's cool.
And we totally did not look at any real estate.
No.
We were just amazed at each other. We were just at home staring at each other.
Not quite, but metaphorically,
Blinking competitions is my favorite.
Staring competition for 72 hours,
No blinking. It's really dry.
Yeah.
So you also have a tea business.
Yeah.
There's like a family business as well. There's a bunch of stuff going on. Right?
Absolutely, absolutely. So the way I've made my living for the last 8 years and the way I've learned to speak and so on is through actually a network marketing company called Organo. And they offer the world's most premium line of gourmet coffees infused with a superfood called reishi. This superfood was actually reserved for the royal family in China thousands of years ago, but a lot of things in the East haven't made it over to the West, especially in terms of the medicine. But I believe that God gave us everything we need to turn our bodies into perfect healing machines with what he gave us on the earth. And this superfood is actually PubMed studied, which means like these are medical facts. These are published medical literature to deal with all types of different challenges, ailments, illnesses, all so on and so forth. And that's actually what I'm drinking right now. It's called the King of Coffee that I'm drinking right now. You can also message me on Instagram if you want more information on that. And it's a life hack. It's really an upgrade for the human body. Every time you drink a cup of coffee, you're getting a dose of life-changing superfoods that's slowly but surely building up health, oxygenation, decreasing inflammation, and creating an environment of homeostasis in your body.
Yeah. People are drinking it every day already.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. You might as well add something that benefits your body in more ways than you'll realize.
Mm-hmm.
It just makes sense.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And then I think Grandmaster Garza, did he say, is there a meat market or a butcher shop, or did I make that up?
No, you made that up. My dad's a chiropractor.
Mm-hmm. man, I thought somebody, I was like, I'm going to go get some meat from somewhere. Who was that? If you're watching and you own a meat market, let me know. I made that up. All right.
It's a detox. You're getting hungry.
I know.
A pierogi talk.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, which is weird. So I'm not a big fan of potatoes, but whenever I have pierogi, I want the potato and farmer's cheese. Mm. It's just so good.
Yeah. Satisfying.
Do
you get it pan fried or you
yes.
get it deep?
Okay. I've tasted them deep fried, but like Polish fries, man, they just cover it. And then like the street pizza, it's good too.
We never had that one.
Haven't had that one yet.
Yeah, there's things that I don't eat, but I'll eat it if it's from Pierogi Queen or Polish because they know what they're doing.
Uh-huh.
And that's one thing, you know, we were talking about Dr. Chapa and Living Well Clinical Nutrition Center.
Yes.
He shares, people think they don't like things, but they probably have not had it prepared the right way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So especially with food and maybe sometimes other things in life, I always try to keep an open mind.
Mm.
I don't like olives. I don't, you know, necessarily like this growing up, but I'm going to try it the way that it was designed to be prepared and keep an open mind because I may find I like it.
Mm-hmm.
So that's that. But thank you guys for hanging out today.
Absolutely.
Thank you for having us.
It's been a blessing sharing this with every single person. And our goal with this is to help more people live in love with life and with God, with themselves and with their soulmate all day long. And if that happens, then this world is a more loving place. And if this world is a more loving place, you know, we begin to see some of the things that God talked about in the Bible, like heaven on earth. You know, heaven is in my mind, it's a place, but it's also a reality that you can live in based on the love in your heart.
Yeah.
And based on what's in your heart, outflows your mouth. And outflows what you see in certain things. You and I may see a certain thing, and a person who's living in love may see a completely different thing. And if everyone's living in love, then this world is a perfect place.
Yeah. Why wait? If you don't have to wait, why wait?
Yeah.
Yeah. So right now it's 10 o'clock. This is KHEA Radio, 99.5 FM. All right, Facebook, y'all be blessed. Hey, don't forget, text Soulmate to 85100. Again, thank you guys for hanging out. If you're watching, you can still share this stream. People will go on and continue to watch it throughout the day. All right, guys. Bye.